My name is Mikhail. My name is Mikhail. I really love me some Z-Ero. I'm not a stinky dragon, nor am I a dirty dragon. Hop on my back and let's go for a ride. Yay! Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. It's time for verse two! My name is Mikhail. My name is Mikhail. I also love me some rotten meat. Give me praise, give me praise, give me praise, give me praise. Telling me I'm the bestest. Hop on my back and let's fly through the sky. Yay!
Hey.
Huh?
There better not be a third verse.
What?
Sing again and I'll kill you.
Fine. Up ahead! I can feel the sun up ahead!
You sure? I didn't think three could fly.
I can feel it, Zero! She's here! I know it!
How does it look up there?
You mean other than the goddamn gargoyle cubes?
Gargoyle cubes? Oh dear.
What's wrong?
Those cubes require massive amounts of magical energy to operate. It's highly doubtful that you think you could ever power them alone. There must be some kind of power source nearby.
Of course there is. Of course!
Redeem thyself, Azrael!
Zero! I think that's an ancient dragon!
I guess that explains all the magical energy. Damn, this is annoying. Quit jumping around!
Ugh. He's too fast for me! I can't aim right! Plus he's scary! His eyes are really scary! I don't like this, Zero! I don't like this at all! Fighting an ancient dragon is bad!
Huh? What do you mean?
It's bad, Zero! I don't know why, I just know! Dragons. We can't fight them.
Don't worry about it. It's gonna be fine.
But Zero, he's...
It's gonna be fine.
But...
Have I ever lied to you?
Well, no. I mean, you're all stabbing and angry and stuff. But no, you never lied to me.
See? So trust me. I'm here with you, and it's going to be okay.
Okay.
Repeat it.
It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay.
Fucking it. This guy sure loves running away, huh? Stupid bastard. Stand still and fight me, shithog. Damn it! How can something that damn big be that damn fast? Decadus? How did you get here?
I had Octa give me a boost.
That's kind of amazing.
You appear to be in some trouble.
Yeah. I can't hit this twitchy son of a bitch.
Leave it to me. My angel holds the power to slow down his movements by a considerable degree.
Sounds great. Get on with it.
Yeah. But if I use such power, I'll go back to being a bird. Your lack of pity is intoxicating.
What? You want to call it off?
You deny me this pleasure? No. I must do this. It is my reward. Armoros! Uphold!
Let's move. Three.
Oh, hey there, Zero.
So the flower is not driving you crazy or anything?
No, I'm A-okay.
I guess you were kind of crazy to begin with.
Look, Zero. Check it out. I summoned an ancient dragon all by myself.
What the hell are you yammering on about?
It's a flower's force at work. See? I'm just like you.
The three I know isn't just cheer.
Oh, really? So I'm just a raven hiding in the veil of night. Just a skeleton beneath the waves. I want to die.
Oh, yeah? I can arrange that.
Just kidding! I've got an ancient dragon on my side. Remember? Now it's your turn to die!
Yeah, one to go.
It sure is quiet now that everyone's gone.
Feeling lonely, are we?
Yeah. Chatting with everyone before bedtime.
No point thinking about it now. Go to sleep.
I really liked having everyone with us, you know?
Why the long face, Octa? Late for your nightly measuring ceremony?
Ah, yes. I tell you, it is really quite strange.
the little scamp won't rise for me tonight. Not a single twitch.
That's unusual.
So much for the great Octa's illustrious career, eh? And just when I had your exclusive attentions, too. Such a shame.
Let's get going.
My lady, if I may, I think the time has come for you to tell me about your flower. Forgive me, my lady. Have I overstepped my bounds?
No, I suppose it's about time. It all started 2 years ago. The first time I saw this flower was the day I died. Now I'm just a corpse being kept alive by the flower's magic. A corpse. My brain, my heart, my body. It's all being kept in motion by the flower. I'm no longer alive in any real sense of the word. This flower is a calamity that threatens the entire world. It's growing, feeding off me. Eventually, it's going to consume me entirely. And once that happens, once it's fully grown, it's going to destroy everything. Pretty shit deal, huh? When I realized I was infected by a flower that was going to end the world, I tried to kill myself. Well, technically I was already dead, but yeah. Anyway, I tried to rip the damn thing out, but in the end, that just made things worse. The flower freaked out, started sprouting these children. Five little girls, one after the other. They burst out of me and ran off before I could blink. Basically, to prevent me from killing it, the flower made copies of me. And that's how I ended up with my sisters. Of course, these children aren't any more alive than I am. So now, the eldest corpse is running around killing all of its little corpse sisters. Insane, isn't it? My sisters took everything from me. They each ran off with a piece of my magic. Or the flower's magic, I guess. At first I tried to recapture her, but they had all my power. I had nothing. You want to know the best part? After a while, my sisters started fighting for peace. They come from a flower that's gonna end the world, and they fight for peace? Hilarious. Anyway, that's when I made my choice. I decided to kill my sisters, and then destroy the flower. I figured I started this whole mess, you know? I might as well finish it. So that's about the long and short of it. That's what this whole thing's about.
Thank you.
As I searched for a way to kill my sisters, I learned there was only one option. If I wanted to put him in the ground for good, I was going to need a dragon. See, to break the flower's magic, only a dragon or a weapon made from a dragon will do the trick. So I joined up with Michael, the strongest dragon of them all. And the two of us worked together.
Michael!
Zero.
Yeah?
Are you certain about this?
What's wrong, Michael? You scared?
Bah, I feel nothing.
A dragon who reneges on his word? That'd be something.
I would never sully myself so.
Then you know what to do. All my sisters are dead. You have to kill me too. Deal?
Agreed.
Well, well. Glad to see you're finally interested in hearing me out.
Yeah.
Though you could sound a bit more thankful, at least.
Just start talking before I tear you apart.
Ooh, scary. Fine, fine. Listen up. For starters, let's talk about your sisters, shall we? You know. The accursed sisters that you're destined to fight? Then, we should talk about how much time you've got left. The final entry in my recording draws near. No matter what conclusion awaits us at the end of this branch, I know that I will never forget this journey.
Sigurd.
So this is one's home base, is it? I'm fine! Go get that guy!
What? Be careful, Zero! Be careful, okay?
Stop repeating yourself! My name is Zero, the original Intoner, and the immortal... Knock it off! I'm trying to make a speech here! Now... Oh, for fuck's sake! Now I lost my place!
Hold her off as long as you can!
For Lady One!
Lady One's counting on us!
She'll be counting your body soon.
I'm going in! Cover me!
Got it!
You can't let them pass you!
I'll confide in light. I'll be Lady One's salvation!
Are you okay, Zero? Are you okay?
Stop repeating things, damn it.
But your flower!
Look, you just worry about killing one. She's a powerful foe. Keeps her magic sealed inside her like pure gold alone. That's how she's managed to stay sane. And you won't be able to beat her if you keep getting distracted.
But...
No buts.
But... what about you, Zero? I don't want to kill you.
It's all right. Everybody dies at some point. And technically, I'm already dead. So you're just helping me close the book.
Oh, man.
Lady One's future is in our hands!
Don't give up! We're still in this!
You dare lose out on
me. No, I'm gonna do this, Zero. I mean, I'll try real hard. I don't understand this, and I don't know if it's right. But I'm gonna try. I mean, I may not ever see you again, right?
You're the only one who can fix things. The world doesn't need intelers.
I completely agree.
Then die already. You first. I can eradicate the intoners as easily as you can.
Like I can trust you? I have to do this myself.
You should talk. You gave birth to this curse. Whether we have the same goal or not, I swear by my murdered sister's soul, I will never forgive you! Now die! 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 Die!
I never asked for forgiveness.
Recording M5310 E0040 GM. The flower's defenses created five sisters from Zero's body. At first, they were simply corpses controlled by the flower. But soon they gained self-awareness and began to act of their own free will. If the flower isn't destroyed, mankind has no future in this branch. Some of us are of the opinion that this branch should be sealed off at once, but I disagree. I think at least one of them might be able to accomplish it. No, I should stop. I'll erase this entry and hand the recording off to the next pass in its current state. End recording.
Homicide! Invade!
Octa!
Oh, A pity we couldn't grind the whetstone one last time, my lady. See? Even in times of crisis, my man's sword is as sharp as a witch's...
Jeez, you're stubborn. Alert! Requesting condition 2-8 under authority 777. Load the following code. Zero. 51.08 seconds from now, the shield will vanish for 0.5 seconds. Accord. Just make sure you're ready. If you die here, this entire branch is going to terminate. So put your money where your mouth is and make this happen!
Understood. Executing code.
You weren't going to interfere.
Yes, but this went a little different than I had planned. However, I think this way was more human, wasn't it?
Yeah, I guess.
Zero, please. I'm a little tired.
Good night, Accord. Tell the whole world I said hi.
Thank you.
Zero.
This is it. Once the flower's in full bloom, you have to destroy it.
Okay.
There's one more thing I need to tell you.
What?
You've grown strong, Mikhail.